Hello friends, please subscribe Target IS and press bell icon to get the notification of the new videos.
Hello students, welcome to Target IES. Today in this video we will be seeing third module of fluid mechanics. So in last module we have seen the bulk modulus, and in this module we will start from vapor pressure. Okay, before going into vapor pressure, I will explain you briefly what will happen here. So basically all liquids have the tendency to vaporize and evaporate. Okay, so what does it mean? We don't need 100 degrees centigrade to evaporate any fluid. Okay, so this is only a myth. So basically all the liquids evaporate at normal temperature also. You just take a glass of water and keep it on a table. Come after a week, okay, you will see the liquid level in this glass has been fallen, right? Itna kyun? Just take the daily example of your home. So basically in Indian homes we daily sweep or clean the floors with water, right? So within few minutes all that water is evaporated. We are not heating the floor to 100 degrees centigrade, right? So that is only a myth. Don't believe in that. Okay, so we are engineers, we should be able to understand all the phenomena perfectly. Evaporation happens at normal temperature also, no issues in it. All the liquids have the tendency to vaporize or evaporate. So let me take a container, a closed container, and let me fill this with fluid, partially filling this with fluid. Okay, so what will happen now? This fluid will try to evaporate and they will form a gaseous molecules. Okay, these gaseous molecules will exert partial pressure on the liquid. At the same time, these gaseous molecules also try to condense and enter back as liquid molecules. Okay, so there is evaporation taking place, and at the same time there is condensation taking place. At the initial phase, as the liquid molecules are very more, the evaporation rate is very high, and the gaseous molecules are very less, so the condensation is very low. But as the time progresses, as the gas molecules accumulate, the condensation rate also increases. Okay, after some time there will be a state reached where the evaporation is equals to condensation. This state is called as equilibrium. Okay, so I told the gaseous molecules will be exerting the partial pressure, right? So the partial pressure being exerted at the equilibrium condition, we call it as saturated vapor pressure. Bas itna hi hai. Very simple concept, right? So let us now see the notes. All molecules have tendency to vaporize or evaporate. We have just seen this. Molecules are continuously project from free surface to atmosphere. Okay. These ejected molecules are in gaseous state and exert own partial pressure on liquid surface. We have just seen this, right? The liquid molecule will evaporate and gaseous molecules are formed. These gaseous molecules will exert partial pressure on the liquid surface. This partial pressure itself is called as vapor pressure. Okay, this pressure is called as vapor pressure of liquid. In equilibrium condition, if equilibrium condition is reached, the vapor pressure is called as saturation vapor pressure. So after some time there will be an equilibrium state formed, that is the evaporation rate will be equals to condensation rate. At this phase, the partial vapor pressure exerted by the gaseous state on the liquids, we call it as saturation vapor pressure. Okay, there are a lot of people who mistakes vapor pressure with saturation vapor pressure. Okay, vapor pressure is a phenomena which you will find at all the conditions, but saturation vapor pressure you will find only at the equilibrium state. Okay, if the pressure of the fluid falls below the vapor pressure, saturated vapor pressure, then the boiling of the liquid will occur. Okay, saturated vapor pressure is represented by P and small Vs. Okay, and vapor pressure is represented by PV. Fine. So basically there is, in schools we have studied If the temperature is raised to 100 degree centigrade, the water will start to boil. Right? Sorry, just a second. There is small vibration. Fine. Okay, let's continue. So, if I heat the water body to 100 degree centigrade, they say the boiling starts. Okay, this is fine up to school level. But at engineering level, if the vapor pressure is more than the pressure of the fluid, then the boiling will start. So, what actually is happening is, so if you take some water sample at atmospheric pressure, what is atmospheric pressure? 760 mm of Hg. Right, or in water it can be written as 10.3 meters of water. Okay, so at 25 degree centigrade the vapor pressure of water is around 2.38 meter of water. Okay, so what is a units? So don't worry about this units, 2.38 meter of water, 10.3 meter of water. If you don't know, please don't get scared. Next chapter in manometry, you will be very clear what I am talking about. Okay. So basically, you can see here at 25 degrees, your PATM is greater than PVS, saturated vapor pressure. So there is no boiling taking place. But as the temperature increases, the vapor pressure also increases. Okay. If I keep on increasing the temperature, my partial vapor pressure also increases. If I am increasing the temperature to 100 degree centigrade for water, then my saturated vapor pressure will become PVS at 100 degree centigrade. Sorry, 100 degree centigrade will be equals to 760 mm of Hg or 10.3 meters of water. Okay, so when this saturated vapor pressure becomes equal to atmospheric vapor pressure, the boiling will start. Okay, itna kuch to school mein nahi padhaya ja sakta hai na. So they simply say if temperature is raised to 100 degree centigrade, water starts to boil. So I hope you are clear what is boiling. Okay, sorry for the disturbances. Now let us continue. Mercury is used in barometer because it has very low vapor pressure. What is the advantage if it has very low vapor pressure? That means mercury likes to be in liquid form, because the low vapor pressure means the partial pressure exerted by the gaseous state is very less. That means the very less molecules of mercury tend to become into gaseous state. Okay. So this is the main advantage why mercury is used in barometer, because it likes to be in liquid state itself. Okay. It doesn't change the state into gaseous state so easily when compared to that of water. Okay. So cavitation depends on the vapor pressure. A काफी important bit है. Cavitation depends on vapor pressure. So what is cavitation? We will learn this concept very clearly when it comes to hydraulic machinery. But now let me explain you briefly what it is. So basically, let us take a section and let us consider two sections, section 1 and section 2. Okay, so let the liquid is flowing. Okay, at section 1, if the pressure of water, a pressure of this fluid at the section 1 is less than vapor pressure, saturated vapor pressure, what will happen? Boiling will happen, right? When the boiling occurs, there will be some bubbles formed. Okay, these bubbles will travel from low pressure area to high pressure area, where the pressure becomes very high compared to saturated vapor pressure. What will happen? This bubble will collapse, right? When these bubbles collapse, they release tremendous amount of energy. So what will happen? These pipes, there will be wear and tear, pitting, and also vibrations will be generated. So cavitation is quite dangerous. So let us see the text. The formation, growth, and collapse of vapor filled cavities or bubbles in the flowing liquid due to local fall in fluid pressure is cavitation. I hope you are very clear, right? Even if you are not clear, don't worry. In hydraulic machinery, we will study this phenomena in very detail. So, cavitation is a low pressure phenomena. Very important. You have to remember this bit. Cavitation is a low pressure phenomena because when the pressure falls below the saturated vapor pressure, only then the cavitation is occurring, right? So it is a low pressure phenomena. It occurs in turbine runners, pump impellers, hydraulic structures like spillway, sluice gate, or ship propellers. Okay. So cavitation causes pitting of the surface, wear and tear, and vibration. We have just seen this, right? I hope you are very clear. For water at 20 degrees centigrade, saturated vapor pressure is 2.38 meters. This bit is very important, okay? So we have seen this, right? Just 5 minutes before, we have seen the saturated vapor pressure of water at 20 degrees centigrade is around 2.38 meters, right? So this you have to remember. So this value is very important. It might be asked in PSUs and PSCs directly, okay? So let us see an example of venturi meter. So venturi meter is a discharge measuring device. We will study this in chapter 4 or 5 in detail, okay? So basically there are two formulae which you might be knowing. One is A1V1 is equals to A2V2. Detail mein padenge, yaar. This is continuity formula, but we will study in detail. So you might at least remember this from your school, college, right? A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. And there is one more equation, which is Bernoulli's equation. P by rho g plus V square by 2g plus z is equal to constant. Or P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus z2, right? Whatever. So basically, as the area decreases, the velocity will increase, right? So dekhiye yahan pe, consider this section 1. So what is happening? The area is decreasing. So as the area decreases, as the discharge should be constant, if area decreases, my velocity will increase. Okay, so my velocity will be increasing in this zone. As the velocity increases, so we know P plus rho g plus V square by 2g should be equal to constant, right? If my velocity is increasing, what will happen to my pressure? Pressure will decrease. Okay. So in the same zone where the velocity is increasing, the pressure will fall. So let us consider at this section, the pressure is minimum, right? If this P minimum is greater than vapor pressure, saturated vapor pressure, then normal flow, there won't be any cavitation occurring. But if P minimum is less than PVS, that is saturated vapor pressure, then the boiling will occur. That is, the bubbles are formed. So therefore cavitation will start. So see here, the bubbles are getting formed, right? So what will happen now? See the zone 2. So in zone 2, the area is increasing. If the area is increasing, to maintain the constant discharge, the velocity will decrease, right? As area increase, my velocity will decrease. As the velocity decreases, Bernoulli's equation, what does it say? P by rho g plus V square by 2g plus z is equals to constant. As the velocity is decreasing, my pressure is increasing. So in this zone, my pressure will start to increase. At some point, these cavities will burst and it will cause pitting or wear and tear of the surface. Okay. So I hope the entire phenomena of cavitation as well as vapor pressure is very clear for you. I hope you will be able to answer all the bits. This concept is very important in PSC exams. So almost all the PSC exams which I have seen, there has been a bit from this section. Okay. So for water at 100 degrees centigrade at sea level, vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure. I have just explained beautifully about boiling at 100 degrees centigrade, right? So the same point is here. For water at 100 degrees centigrade at sea level, vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure. So this ends vapor pressure concept. So in the next module, we will be seeing the surface tension. Okay. So I want to recommend you this course. If you have not yet subscribed to this course, please do subscribe. So visit this Target IES, and in the below description you will find the link to buy this course. If you buy this course, you will be getting this material at your doorsteps. Okay, you need not write all these concepts. So by this time you have understand that this book has all the concepts, right? So we will slowly do all the problems. This book also has a lot of problems. Once you are done with concept, we will see problems also. So you have to, this book is perfect for all the exams, whether it is GATE, ESC or any state PSCs, Public Service Commission examinations or any PSU exams. Okay, this material is the perfect material. If you have this, you will be scoring very good at all these exams. Okay, so I highly recommend you to check the link and buy this package. It is very affordable price, because all these videos won't be available on YouTube. Only few videos are going to the YouTube and remaining will be hidden. So if you are paying only, then you can watch the remaining all videos. Okay, so basically as the fluid mechanics subject progresses, it gets little difficult, but I assure you that I will be making the concepts very easy. Okay, trust me. Using these notes, I have cracked a state PSC exam rank 1. So this material will be very useful to you to crack any of the exams. Okay, so all the best. See you in the next module.